Yes, Gurveen, you can start now.
Hi everyone, this is Gurveen here, and today we'll be having a look at how we can implement authorization for a UI component, and we'll also see this through some examples that how we can give different users different kind of access to the different screens in the UI component. And we'll also quickly have a look at if we want to set the artifact authorization for an entity or a service in a package, how we can do so. So I have come here in the Mocky documentation under the security. So in the previous session, we talked about the steps of how we can configure the data for adding artifact authorization for a REST a kind of artifact. So in this session, we will see how we can do so for a UI component which have different screens. So before that, let's see that why this is needed. So I will jump to the IDE. So for the demo purpose, I will use the example component which is there in the Mocky GitHub repository. So say I have developed my component and I've added some screens. As we can see, we have a root screen, we have many screens. The example has features, items associated with it. And I've also set my root screen in the web root. So now if someone is starting with the Mocky development, so it might come to the mind that once I'm done with this, I have set my screens, I've done the development. Now I should be able to use my application. It should be visible and I should be able to access that. But if we also recall the session of customizing UI by Namit, he also mentioned that we need to add some security data, which will actually make our component visible after these steps, and then only we should be able to access it. So let us just once check that. So what I will do is I have my Mocky running. Let me just come again from starting. Yeah. So I'm using the test user John Doe and I will try to log in. I don't have any security data set up for the example component right now. So as you can see, I'm not able to view the example component as a menu here. So this shows that we need to add some data, some configuration needs to be added so that it is accessible. So we'll check what kind of data we need to add for this. So I've come to the example security data file. So we'll be using the artifact group and artifact group member and artifact authorization records as we have discussed earlier. So let us see that for giving the authorization for whole of the example app, how we can do so. So we have added one artifact group and given an ID, and then we will add the group member for my root screen. So here the artifact type will be at XML screen. And the artifact name should be the literal value of my screen location. And I have set the inherit authorization to true. So just for just to explain this again, so inheritable authorization, if we have set it as Y, this means that not only the specific artifact which we have mentioned is authorized, but everything else which it is using will also be authorized along with it. Then I need to set the artifact authorization record. So the user which we are using is of type admin. So we can give the user group for which we want to add the authorization. And we need to give the artifact group ID for which we are setting this up. And we have currently given all authorization to this user group for and the authorization type is set as always. So we have seen that we can give here the type as allow, deny, or always. So for this example, we have given all the permissions, full permissions to the admin user group. So the next step is we need to load the data. So once we load this data up, So we should expect that the authorization record is correctly set and the user should be able to access the screen. It should be visible, and let's see if he's able to access and navigate inside the example application. So once this is loaded, I'll quickly run the app. Now I'll just go to the browser again. Let me refresh this. So now we can see that the example component is visible and the user has access to the component. So if I navigate inside, so I am able to use everything what the application is using. So I'm able to see the list of the example entity data. If I go inside, there are some edit example screens which I can perform the different kind of actions. I can update or I can add items, features or content. So this was one example. If I go back to my IDE, so we have seen that currently we have added only one artifact group member to this, and that was the example of screen. So I would like to jump to the demo data file. So say if I want to set the authorization for my entities or the services in my component, so there may be a requirement that there are some direct calls happening to an entity or a service for which you need to give the authorization. So you can do that. So the for this example, what you need to do is the artifact type will be @service. And the artifact name can also take a regular expression kind of value. So this, the example here means that so we are giving access to all the services defined in the mocky.example package. And for this, we need to set the field of name is pattern to true, indicating that there is a pattern and we need to give access which is matching this expression. Similarly, we can do for the entities. So the artifact type will be @entity, and the artifact name, again, we can give it like an expression. So what? So all the entities which are matching the package name of the artifact name will be given the access for the user group for which we are trying to give the authorization. Now, the examples which we have seen, so in the real world scenario, now we might have different kind of users for which we have to restrict some authorization actions, or we want to limit this access to different screens in our application. So let us see how we can do that. So this example component is available in the Mocky GitHub repository, and I have modified this file to create some of the examples. So let us just check. Now see, I have a hierarchy of users in my application. So I have a super user kind of user, say admin user, who can perform all the actions. But I also have a user for which I just want to give the view access. So I can do that. So just for the example, we have created some user groups and given a name, added some users to the user group. Say it is example of a viewer kind of user. And the same artifact group ID we can use, and we can just set a new authorization record. So here we have given the authorization action as only view, and we have allowed the and we have set the authorization type as allow. So once we have done this, let us see what effect it has on our UI. So I will just log in with this user now. Let me log out. So yes, I think this is another good example that since this was a new user group, so we can see that we can only see the example component. So in whole of our Mocky project, we have not given authorization for this new user group to any of the component. So we can only see the example. So if I go inside, I'm able to see the example data. And if I navigate to one of the examples, we can see that I'm not able to edit the records here. So I think Mocky handles this very nicely so that we can set up various authorization actions for different users in our application. Now, this is with respect to a particular action. Now, there may be, now if we say we want to set up a limited user, say he has access to some operations, but we want to revoke the permission for, say, I don't want a user to upload content. I want the user to be able to add example items, but I do not want that he should be able to add any content to the application. So let's see how we can do so. So for this, so as we have discussed that there are various artifact authorization types. So like we have allow, we have deny, and we have always. So what we will do is, so this user has access to all the example screens, and we have set the inheritable authorization as true for the example application. So let me just see. So the so we have created a new artifact group ID, and I don't want the user to have access to one of the screens. So I want to remove the access to a subscreen for a user. So this is the new artifact group we have created, and I have given the location of the screen for which I don't want the user to have access to. And the important thing is that we have set the authorization type as deny here. And the let's see now whether he should be able to access the screen or not. So we have added some data for the user group, for the limited user, and added some users. So I will use this user to just log in. So let me go inside. The user is verified. So now if I see I'm able to use this example screens, let me go inside. And now we can see that we do not have the content option. So like this, we can have the different combinations of authorizations which we want to set for our application. So I think I would like to add that Mocky is providing us the way of setting the artifact authorization at each and every level. But I think this should be something which need to be think through properly, and then we need to implement the authorization as per our requirement for our application need. So, and the if we want to see that how Mocky actually handles the various authorizations, so I just want to cover the artifact execution stack here. So we know that Mocky has different facades, like it has user facade, message facade. So we also have artifact execution facade here, which actually keeps track of all the artifacts which are being executed. So say I have a call to a screen, which in turn has a call to a service, and which is doing an entity find on an entity. So what it does is it will keep a stack of all this artifacts. So on the bottom, we will have an artifact of screen. Then on the top of it, we'll have a service. And then on top of it, we'll have entity. Now the main purpose how Mocky uses this is, of course, we can use it for debugging purposes. But the main is what we have talked about is inheritable authorization. So since we know that we have set the inheritable authorization true for the screen, so it is easier so that we know that all the artifacts which are being called by the screen will be given the authorization for the user. So I think with the mix of different authorization types and the different allow and deny records, we can set the authorization for the for our application. So, is there anything we can discuss here? So this was for the screen authorization.
There is this thing at the bottom of that document.
Yes.
Something called TARPIT something. Related to authorization. Yes. Can you talk about that thing a little bit?
Yes.
TARPIT. Yes. This one.
Yes. I think we can also talk about entity filter sets as well. So let's cover both. Yes. So right now we have seen that the authorization types which we were talking were respect to an artifact. So there may also be a requirement that we want to set it at the record level. So this is one more way which we can add authorization. So if we talk about an example, say so we have an organization entity in Mocky, and we want to I just want the records for a user which he, for the organization he is a part of. He should not be able to view other records. So this is something which we might need to set at the record level. So for this, Mocky provides us with entity filter set and artifact authorization filter. So we can just check this once. So we have artifact authorization filter in the artifact authorization. So what it will do is, so for the filter, we need to set the condition and we need to add that what conditions will be applied for the entity which is being called so that the records can be filtered out. So in turn, this has a association to entity filter. So here we need to give the entity name and then we can give the filter map. So filter map will actually contain the conditions which we want to filter on the particular organization IDs so that we can add it in the filter map. So I think one example which is given here, so it is there in the Mantle USL component. So we can set the we can always set the entity filter sets. So let us just see the example once. If I'll go to Mantle USL, I think we have it in the Mantle setup data. Yes, it's there in the Mantle install data. So they are using the user organization entity filters. So this is how we can set an entity filter set. And they have set the entity for different scenarios, say different entity names. And the filter maps is having a condition on the fields of the entity on which this will be applied. And then we have the join or. So if we set it to Y, the condition will be OR between these two filters. If you set it to N, it will be AND between these two filters. And then if we talk about artifact TARPIT, so artifact TARPIT is something which will actually help us in limiting the access to the artifacts in a group. So say I have some screen and I want to limit the user to access the screen for a particular seconds. So I can do so. So for this you need to set the artifact TARPIT as, so we can set the artifact group ID, and we have one max hits count and max hits duration. So what it does is that it will restrict this user group to these screens for 60 seconds. And if we have more than 120 hits, then the user will be locked. So this is how we can restrict a user for the access to an artifact. And also, if the authorization is failing, what Mocky does is it creates a record in the artifact authorization failure table. So we can always go and check the table for the failed authorizations for the debugging purposes. So this is it from my end. Yes, so we have the target duration as 60 seconds. So let us just once go through this. So this is target duration is the duration for how long it is restricting the access of the user to that particular artifact. Is there anything which we can discuss? Please let us know. Okay, we have a question. Max hits count and max hits time both work simultaneously. Okay, actually this is something which I have not explored, but let me just check. I think they will both work simultaneously. So as it checks the hits count for that duration, so it will always according to my I think what it will do is it will check the how many hits are there for this particular duration. So I think it will be using both of these values for the artifact target. But I think we can always check this and explore so that we will be sure that this is how it behaves.
Is there any other question? Well, I think we are good for now. So, thank you very much, Guruji, for this fruitful session. And for follow-up questions, definitely all of us can reach out to Stack Overflow or the Mocky Google groups that we have subscribed. And do the discussions. This session recording will also be made available on YouTube for the references for all of us. So thank you so much, everyone, for sparing your time this morning for this fruitful session. Thank you so much, Govind.
Yeah, thank you all for joining.
Thank you.